Well, when I finished the record at the end of last summer, I had the situation where I have to get my band together. And rather than just go out with the tape deck and a fog machine or something, decided to make it a ridiculous live kind of thing with people sweating and kind of convey the energy that the record tried to convey and the honesty that the record tried to convey in a live setting. And just to make it interesting, we try to be as ridiculous as possible. And, you know, sometimes Rich gets hurt. Which has some unique scarification that we've been working on this tour. This was from a couple days ago. Today he's got some nice ones on part of his body we can't show on TV. Desperate for entertainment back here.
Right now we're backstage at the Lollapalooza show, the opening night of the tour, with Trent and Richard from Nine Inch Nails. Now you've played some fair-sized venues before, Trent, but nothing quite like this, and not with this many other different kinds of bands. How do you think, it's going to go well with this kind of lineup?
Well, we're prepared for an incredibly hostile reaction, but it can only get better from there. I think it'll be going all right, but it's a challenge to put our show in an outdoor, daylight, hot type environment, so we'll see what happens.
Thank you. Okay, what just happened?
Well, we were officially the first casualty of the Lollapalooza tour here in Phoenix, Arizona. And I guess what happened is a lot of our equipment in the back was sitting in the sun for quite a long time, baking in the desert heat. And since we are an electronic-based kind of band, when the main part of your sound becomes ruined and melted, which I think is what happened, it was cutting out and just becoming a nightmare. And complemented with incompetence on the crew part led to a disastrous, embarrassing situation. So, I mean, we want to really apologize to our fans in Phoenix that came out to see us because we really wanted to do a good show. And it was a nightmare.
Did you actually stop right in the middle of a song?
Oh, we had to. So, yeah, second song, same thing happened, so it was time to cut our losses and maybe entertain people by smashing our expensive equipment instead of committing social suicide on stage. Growing up, it's always what I wanted to do, you know. And then when you get old enough, you realize, is this really what I want to do now? You know, is this what's going to make me happy? I don't know. I'm not achieved a great amount of happiness with success, but not that we're a great little success. But I'm just doing what I feel I'm here to do. You know, if someone can relate to it, you see people that say, "Hey, your album just helped me out of some emotional situation." That's the connection that would be great to make, you know.
I found
like playing big venues. I much prefer clubs where people can interact. It's very impersonal when you're miles away from people. See, the way equipment works with us is if it messes up on you, it has to pay the price. So it had to pay for what it had done. It caused an embarrassment to us. Ultimately, we pay. It doesn't really make sense, but it seems like the right thing to do at the time.
Thank you. logistics, the compromise of doing this album. I don't want to lose too much of the screen, but obviously I want to be, but I want to come out really, I want to really tight on you, and then gradually it comes out so wide, you just get to see the screen behind you.
Will you ever see the edge of the screen? Or?
No, I don't want to, the whole thing is limited, it's not saying I'm in a studio. It's
good.
It's just, it could be anywhere. Very small. Now, what are we going to do when we go back?
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel right. Focus on the only thing that's real.
It's the whole performance thing I wanted to do. This is something I wanted to try and get across. Is that for a start, with this song on stage, you never see, there's above it. There are elements, come and go, silhouettes and stuff like that. But performance.
But nobody says it doesn't work.
No.
And you also get to see the projections, which was the most exciting element of this thing. Whereas now, maybe. I know the lighting's not right, but I don't pay one second. I know I'm looking at me and I'm studying my own performance, but I'm more looking at someone standing than I am, what I think is more interesting. What's going on behind it? And there's no coming in and out. It's, here's a guy, and eventually you see enough of what is more interesting. But I'm interested. I'm not trying to get down on this, so I'm willing to pursue it to see what we get out of it.
Let's.
doing, and they both look like
they're about an inch and a half long.
Inch and a half long. Can you touch them with your tongue?
Yeah, I
can. Can you do it now?
Huh?
Can you do it now?
Yeah, I can, baby.
I have my fingers in my ass.
How many fingers do you have in your ass?
Huh?
What? How many fingers do you have in your ass?
Just two for now.
I like that.
I'm pacing myself. Yeah. On a good day, I can fit most of my hand in it.
Most of it?
Most of it. Up until the thumb knuckle. Wristwatch, Crisco.
You have a dildo in your hand?
A dildo? That's old hats to me, sweetheart. Tell me you wanna fuck it.
Oh, I wanna fuck it. I wanna fuck your dick so hard.
Tell me you wanna fuck my 9-inch nail.
Oh, I wanna.
86,
boy. Fuck your 9-inch nail.
Say it again, but mean it.
Oh, I wanna fuck your 9-inch nail.
Tell me you wanna fuck my 9-inch nail.
That's my favorite one.
What are your nipples?
We pay $16 a minute.
What are your nipples?
That's the one?
Yeah. What are your nipples look like? 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 What are your nipples look like?
Thank you. There's two different chord changes. That one, and one where it's slightly different.
Yeah.
Instead of going, it goes. And that's when it goes. That's the only time it does that. So what I'll do if you want, do you want to fuck around and get a sound that you like and just play through the song a few times and record it from there. We'll be right back.
Back then I couldn't do
now, I know it's still the same. Everywhere I look, you're all I see. Just a fading fucking reminder of who I used to be. Come on, tell me, you make this all go away. You make this all go away. I'm down to just one thing. I'm starting to scare myself. You make this all go away. You make this all go away.
Understand how I feel.